If you were listening to this without knowing who she is, you would think she was like a mature woman. Oh my god, we're recording. Oops. Hey, good, you guys, what's going on? Claudia here, welcome back. So I apologize about this delay on this video. I wanted to get it done the minute it came out, but life happens. Anyway, not the point, we're doing it now, we're doing it today. So this is Angela Jordan has come out with a new single, Seventh Heaven. I did see on her Instagram that she's been in studio recording more and recording more videos or songs, writing more music. I could see she had up a picture of her in the studio, I think, the other day. And it was like more music or creating music. So it's really great to see that she is being able to, you know, create and push out music now. And I can't wait to see what she comes out with. But this is one of them. This is Seventh Heaven. And she looks so cool in the art for it. She looks just so angelic, but very age appropriate. And I just am really excited to see what she does. So here we go. This is Angela Jordan, Seventh Heaven. Oh, it's a bit upbeat than I usually listen to from her. I'm reading the lyrics, by the way. She sounds so grown up. She sounds like very Amy Winehouse-ish. Oh, run. I'm gone to heaven. If you were listening to this without knowing who she is, you would think she was like a mature woman. I love the lyrics as well. Nice message. Those runs. I hope she stays on this journey. Ooh, layers. Ooh. Life should live with hope. Oh my goodness. I want her to stay on this path. She needs to keep that very, very last part there right after she stops. You hear that little like noise? It sounds like a when you take the needle off the vinyl. Is that right? That sound? Like breakaway sound? Did you hear it? Does anyone hear that at the end? That tiny little like noise, like that's just for some reason like really Angelina. I can see that happening. It's a very like old vibe. You can hear it at the end. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go back and watch it. You can hear the noise take off at the end. I think that's what it is, unless my headphones are broken. But that was magical. Like that got your fingers snapping, head bopping. You know, if you can't listen to a song and not like bop. It's a bop. Her voice, she sounds like if you didn't like know who she was, or, you know her age or her story. If you listen to that, just out of whatever, like, you would think that that was like a mature woman in like her 20s, because her voice is so mature and so controlled. I think anyone would listen to that and just not like or deny her vocal ability. And it's such a bop, like, it's just one of those easy songs that I don't think many people could dislike. I don't know why it's not everywhere. I mean, are the label are obviously pushing it, aren't they? Is it being promoted? Yeah, like, her voice is so uniquely her own. I love that she isn't trying to do something that, you know, or be someone that she's not. She's sticking to the kind of music that I think she likes and the kind of music she wants to create. That's what I'm getting out of it anyway, so I hope that's the case. But I'm so happy for her. I'm so happy for her. And the lyrics as well, very easygoing, but like really nice little messages in there. Sometimes I feel all my dreams are slowly fading. I see myself in the mirror and I want to love the person looking back at me. Sometimes you have to let go and get lost in the moment. Sometimes you want to be careless and let go of sadness. Like, that's really like such a nice way to put such like meaningful lyrics. Like, she still always has her little twists on it. I love it. I am so happy for her. I'm so proud of her. I cannot wait to see what else she comes out with. Is she on Spotify and stuff? Does anyone know this? Do we know? Is she on Spotify and like iTunes and everything? I'm gonna guess they are, because of the label that she signed to. Like, Republic Records is like one of the biggest record labels there is. I know, because I get copyrighted by them all the time, so I know that you know, they usually have their basics crossed and stuff. I love it. I love the undertones, and I love that it's not overcomplicated either. Like, it's not this huge filled chorus. Like, it's just her voice with a bit of you know, instruments in the back, and like just the snap of it all. Like, that's all she really needs. And she still very much has those influences there. While she starts seeing Billie Holiday, and, you know, Ella Fitzgerald, Amy Winehouse, all that kind of stuff, you can hear that in there. And that's obviously what she started singing really when she was on all the, you know, shows. I'm gonna go. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to stay safe out there. Make sure to wash your face, wash your hands, wash your ass, and everything between. Wear a mask, and I will see you guys in the next video. Goodbye. Go stream. Go buy the song. Go love, support, and enjoy. Bye, guys. Bye.